Good evening, everyone, and I hope you can hear me loud and clear. Yes?
Yes, yes, please go ahead.
Loud and clear.
Yes.
Wonderful, wonderful. Over to you, Pearl.
Yes. Good evening, everyone, and a warm welcome to all of you to the S Factor Talk Show. I'm very glad to be with you all on this beautiful Friday evening, and I'm so excited for this talk show with all of you. I'm Paul D'Souza, and I'm also a member of the S Factor Talk Show. I want to welcome all of you to this talk show. And for those of you who are new to this talk show, the S Factor is a global initiative by two ambitious thought leaders, director of Ecosol Global, Samira Fernandez, and CEO of Chevins Entertainment, Shekhar Vijayan. And it has now crossed over 20 countries in less than a month of its inception. The talk show is all about discussing and deliberating with key influencers and thought leaders on how to make the society progressive and positive. It has garnered great momentum due to its unique style of engaging with key influencers and, most importantly, inviting views and participation of the global audience. Senior leaders from the media, education, entertainment have previously been panelists on the talk show, and it has sparked the interest of the business community and thought leaders from all around the world because of the unique and innovative conversations around things that matter. I'd also like to introduce to you our vibrant and dynamic hosts of the day, Shekhar Vijayan and Samira Fernandez. Shekhar Vijayan is an entertainer, author, actor, motivational speaker, columnist, radio jockey, and NLP coach, whose only aim in life is to make his dog laugh. Shekhar has engaged with multicultural clients across the world in places as diverse as New York City to the Indian diaspora in Australia. Shekhar, in the post-COVID world, is more often than not found on channels like Republic TV, India Today, Times Now, and Mirror Now, championing the causes of a sustainable environment, global governance, and leadership. I'd also like to welcome to you our co-host and the co-founder of the S Factor Talk Show, Samira Fernandez. Samira Fernandez is the director of Ecosol Global. She's also the Nirbhaya Award winner and chairperson of the External Affairs Expert Committee, Bangalore Chamber of Industry and Commerce, BCIC. She is the former director of strategy at St. Francis College. She is also the author of two books, Educating the Next and The Price of Truth, released by Honorable Deputy Chief Minister Dr. C.N. Ashwath Narayan in 2021. She is a seasoned marketing communications and CSR professional with over 19 plus years of experience, multicultural expertise, and international exposure, backed by experience in working for both private companies and multinationals in diversified industries. She has focused on building the company's global brand presence through strategic marketing communications programs and reputation management. Before we begin the session, there are a few guidelines that I would like to announce to all the attendees of this session. Since this is an online session, I request all of you to keep your videos on and audios muted for the entire duration of the session. Please feel free to share your thoughts in the chat section and to engage in the discussion. Please connect with us on all our social media platforms, which we will be posting in the chat section. And in case you are attending the session and haven't registered through the Google form, I request all of you to register through the Google form link, which will also be posted in the chat section, to avail your free e-certificate after the webinar. In today's session, which is called Pursuit of the Truth, we have vibrant media personalities, such as the executive coach and show host Anjan, senior special correspondent with India Today TV, Nolan Pinto, CA Valerian Dalmeida of News Karnataka, a voiceover artist and a former radio presenter, Melody Austin, Bansi Kalappa of the New Indian Express, and senior correspondent of Mirror Now, Shrija MS. And they will discuss on how they rightfully resonate the pulse of the nation. We at the S Factor Talk Show team hope that you will truly enjoy this session and benefit from this session. Now I hand it over to Shekhar Vijayan to introduce the speakers.
Thank you, Pearl. I was just checking whether I was on mute or not, because nowadays in all Zoom calls, we all start with, am I audible? Are you audible? Can we see each other? And everything goes like that. So before we start, can we get everybody on video, please? Because it's nice to see familiar faces on video. It'll be nice to see all of you on video rather than hearing our wonderful voices, that is. While Pearl gets our episodes up and running. So this is what we're talking about, Pursuit of the Truth. And today is our 11th episode. And, you know, it's been a very interesting ride so far. We've had some very interesting thought leaders, very interesting influencers. We've had some very interesting entrepreneurs, environmentalists, you name it, we have got them. I think all we're missing out now is getting Mr. Modi on the show, which will happen sooner or later. But on a more serious note, today's episode is very interesting. We're really looking forward to hearing all our wonderful, I would call them influencers, thought leaders, all our wonderful truth seekers or truth followers or however you like it, on this very interesting show talking about their pursuit of the truth. And as we talk, we've got some very interesting guests. We've got Mr. Anjan Ganesh, who I know was in Bangalore a long time back, and I've heard many, many interesting stories and many positive stories about him. Anjan, welcome to this wonderful show. It's so nice to see you. Anjan is a practical yogi who leads private and group meditation sessions. He's a multi-potentialite with varied business interests across domains. He's presently the evening drive time radio show travel host on Talk 100.3 in UAE, which is a UAE-based premium talk radio station. He's also the founder of Yoga Trippy, a yoga travel company. He's a mentor for Yoga Shippy, a holistic store for yoga, meditation, and wellness products. His background spans over 15 years with experience in domains of radio, tourism, digital agencies, event companies, music labels, advertising, PR firms, conference productions, and TV. In 2009, Anjan became runners-up and only Indian finalist from over 1 lakh finalists worldwide to be selected for the award-winning Best Job in the World campaign by Tourism Queensland. I also got a chance to watch the video. I think it's very interesting, very inspiring, and very passionate. He was subsequently announced as Tourism Ambassador to India. Anjan is also an MC, a conscious DJ, and a podcaster. Anjan, a warm welcome to this wonderful show today. We are honored and humbled to have you in our presence. Thank you so much, Anjan. We've also got Melody Austin. Melody Austin, in her words, is a badass nation, My Body Beautiful winner, 2021 voiceover. She's a radio presenter for 15 years, having worked at Fever 104, Indigo 91.9, Radio 1, 94.3, and All India Radio. She's a voiceover artist and compare and has been one for the last 20 years. She has worked with the startup Eurasian Business Concept and mobile application, notified as a proofreader, content and social media manager. She currently freelances as a voiceover artist and compare. She's a dynamic, versatile, committed professional who has a diverse range of skills and capabilities which can be finely tuned to meet a number of projects or workplace requirements. Melody, welcome to the show. And I can tell you, Sunshine, very excited to see you because I think we have a Sunshine connection somewhere. We've also got Srija MS. Srija MS is an award-winning television journalist with over 8 years of experience in broadcast, print, and digital media. She's currently a senior reporter for the Mirror Now. As a correspondent with Mirror Now, Times Network, she has been part of news gathering operations for the network from Karnataka. Srija moved up the ranks to become a full-time producer and reporter with Mirror Now, Times Network, Newsable, Asianet News, and News 9. She's also worked as a reporter for the Times of India, CNN and IBN News Channel, and NDTV. Srija, welcome to this wonderful show. We call this the S Factor Talk Show, and this is The Pursuit of the Truth. Samira, over to you.
Shekhar, absolutely excited to be here today to know about some of the latest innovative trends in the media and what's really going on in the world. And we have with us such eminent personalities. And to continue naming the others, special guest speakers with us, we have Mr. Valerian Dalmeida, who is currently associated with newskarnataka.com. Apart from being, from the Mysore University, don't get me wrong, although he is overseas at the moment, he is very much Indian at heart. He is also a fellow member of the Indian Institute of Chartered Accountants and a certified support manager for Services Strategies, California, USA. He was the program host, mentor, and shareholder at Spearhead Media Group. He is an investor and positive media proponent and advisor to the Emirates Suratkal Parishioners Association. He was also elected the second time the president of the KCO. Well, apart from being a very good friend of mine, he's also the founder of News Karnataka, which features us live on all their platforms. A warm welcome to you, Mr. Valerian Dalmeida, to our show. We also have with us, very known figure in the media who people can resonate with, Mr. Bansi Kalapa, with his passion for journalism. Bansi Kalapa was a special correspondent at TV9 News 9. He is currently a news journalist at the New Indian Express. He also worked as a reporter for the Times of India, used to teach at the Bangalore Central University as a visiting faculty, and served as a guest faculty in many educational institutions, and is also a member of the Board of Studies at St. Joseph's College, Bangalore. With this, we also have with us Mr. Nolan Pinto, who's been a TV journalist for more than a decade now, and his interest in stories that matter really helps us connect with the common man, the prevailing environment of civic, animal welfare, crime, and many other pertinent issues prevalent in the system. His recent interests have taken him to focus on political issues plaguing the nation, especially Karnataka. And, we really find his talks extremely fascinating. Nolan joined the television media after completing his master's in military history from the University of Glasgow. He is currently a senior special correspondent with the India Today TV. A warm welcome to you all, my dear friends, our special guest of today, and here with us on the talk show, the S Factor talk show, with the episode number 11, The Pursuit of Truth. Before we continue, I would also like to acknowledge all our sponsors, Ecosol Global, Chevins Entertainment, Bupalam Botanicals, Cicada Media, I Am Here, Enablers, Westland, News Karnataka, DuPont, Eat Raja, Threadworks, Elephant Marketing, Sunshine Bakers, E-Transform, Peppercoin, Yoga Andrini, Jagruti Education, and Motherhood Hospitals. Over to you, Shekhar.
Thank you, Samira. That's such a wonderful introduction you just gave to all our fellow panelists. And before we start, I think we might have to do this again. Anjan just joined us once again. I think there is a bad connection out there in Dubai. Anjan, this is just for you. We're going to do this once again because he just missed out and he lost his connection. So once again, Anjan is a practical yogi who leads private and group meditation sessions. He's a multi-potentialite with varied business interests across domains. He's presently the evening drive time radio show host on Talk 100.3 at UAE, which is a UAE-based premium talk radio station. He's also the founder of Yoga Trippy, a yoga travel company. He's a mentor for Yoga Shopee, a holistic store for yoga, meditation, and wellness products. His background spans over 15 years with experience in domains of radio, tourism, digital agencies, event companies, music labels, advertising, PR firms, conference productions, and TV. In 2009, Anjan became runners-up and only Indian finalist from over 1 lakh finalists worldwide to be selected for the award-winning Best Job in the World campaign by Tourism Queensland. I had a chance to watch the show. I think it was very interesting, and it was a proud moment for all Indians and for all entertainers and entrepreneurs worldwide. He was subsequently announced as Tourism Ambassador to India. Anjan is also an MC, a conscious DJ, and a podcaster. And on that note, Anjan, I think we'll start the first question with you. And a warm welcome to all our wonderful panelists who have joined us on the show today. Anjan, hopefully you can hear us now. Anjan, this question is for you, and then we'll start with everybody else. The question is very simple. Anjan, when you talk about the pursuit of the truth and looking at the wide experience you have across various domains in terms of entertainment and in terms of the various passion areas you have, what exactly is the right approach for you in terms of truth? Because we're all seeking the truth, right? And I think your background says it all.
Shekhar, Samira, thanks for putting this together. Thanks for having me. Namaste to everybody. Hi, a lot of familiar faces, Melody, and whoever I can see on my screen, Sunil, Pearl, thank you so much. Nolan, long time no see, how you been? In the yogic system, the word for truth is satya. And this goes beyond the external Western understanding of the word satya and goes to a deep inner understanding of who we truly are. So for me, the pursuit of truth is futile. Our only job is to remember the truth of who we are as humans, enjoying this dimension of human experience. And at the same time, remembering we're actually more than just this human experience. So occasionally people say, I'm a human being having temporary spiritual experiences, but the remembrance of truth is to remember that you're a spiritual being enjoying this human experience. So I hope this didn't go too deep or philosophical, because I am a practical yogi and I apply these ancient concepts of Tantra and yoga for practical life. But in all honesty, truth is something you don't need to pursue. As long as you can look within, you will find satya. I hope that answers your question, Samir.
You just set the ball rolling. And I think, your backdrop, which means Om, I think Om has over 100 meanings. And one of them is welcome to the gods. And we are welcoming our guests in that manner. And Melody, over to you. I would love to know your perspective on the pursuit for truth, because you've done so many things under the sun. And would love to know and you've got a lot of fans out here who are actually asking about you on the message box. So please tell us your perspective.
Sure. Once again, a very good evening to everyone, Samira and Shekhar. This is just one amazing platform. I'm so glad you put this together. I echo Anjan's sentiments as well. Hey, Anjan, it's been a really long time, but it's so good to see you. And of course, my fellow panelists, a very good evening to you, Shrija, Bansi, Valerian, and Nolan. I had a chance to speak to Nolan 2 weeks ago, so it's really great. I just love this forum. I mean, like, we've all got like-minded people coming together on this platform, and special thanks to Samira, because, I actually spoke to her last week and she said, we'd love to have you. And I said, no, I don't think I can do this. But she said, no, you've been here. We've listened to you for so long, for so many years. You're definitely going to, give us a little bit of value add. And yeah, I hope I can. And like you said, Shekhar, yes, I've done all kinds of things. Being in the radio space, being a content writer, being an MC, being a voiceover artist. And in fact, I don't want to move away from what Anjan said, because that's exactly what it is. I mean, we are always looking for the truth. You don't have to pursue, not just truth. We're always trying to pursue so many different things in our lives. But, it has to come from within. It's that spirit, that burning spirit that is within each of us. All of us have that inner strength and spirit. And I think that is what takes us to places. And that is what gives us these experiences that we can share with one another, that we can share with the whole world. So like Anjan, I am always never in pursuit of anything, far away from the truth. I always like to be in the moment and experience, life as it is right in front of me, because we don't know, like him, I don't want to get too deep, because we don't know if there is a tomorrow, but when we all come together and we discuss something like the pursuit of truth, we can find out from one another what exactly is this pursuit that we're looking for. But in my opinion, in my personal opinion, I never look in search for anything. I'd like to live the moment. And that is what has gotten me this far. And that is what I truly believe in. And it will get all of us in whichever directions that we're looking for, you know, whatever dreams and goals and aspirations that we're looking at. I think just being in the moment and being yourself is enough. So you don't really need to pursue something in particular. But great topic. And I'm so glad I'm part of this. And I'd love to share with everybody my views and, you know, together, one another, you know, we can bring this together and see where we can take this from here. Thank you so much for the time.
Thank you, Melody, on those on that melodious note and on that spiritual and philosophical note. I think you just hit the ball. And Srija, we would love your perspective also on this. I think Srija's on mute.
Am I audible now? Great. First of all, thank you for having me on this show. And I'm so glad to be sharing the space with, you know, some of the eminent people. Of course, I do resonate my thoughts with Melody as well and Anjan. But you know, Melody did point to the fact that I don't really, you know, we are always far away from the truth and we don't really pursue. But it's slightly different if you're talking, you know, if you're asking me, especially for the journalists in the television medium, or even for that matter, even the print medium, because we are all, you know, intertwined and we are involved in that kind of, you know, the companies, you know, what we have to do and what we have to get them for. So if you're asking me personally, then of course I can agree to what Melody is saying, but that is very far, far from what I am actually doing. Because today, if you're talking about the pursuit of truth, I feel it's kind of superficial for the media. And also considering, you know, the cross sections of the media that we have been witnessing over the last 5 to 10 years in terms of, I'm talking about how social media has completely taken over. And today news is more about narratives. You know, people don't really connect with news at all. They hardly do connect with news. It's everybody is just out there, you know, wanting to putting out, you know, they want to put out the news, be it a Twitter or Facebook. So everybody is just out there, but, you know, not really understanding what exactly are we putting for or what really is the purpose, because everybody wants to be out there. So somewhere when you're talking to me about the pursuit of truth, I don't really see that in this.
Right. And that's exactly why we've got all of you on this platform. You hear all these different voices. Samira, what do you say?
Exactly. You know, diverse opinions make a big difference in shaping our perspective and our world. And with that, you know, very prominent perspective, I would like to now ask Valerian. Valerian, you're the founder of, you know, News Karnataka, spreading up-to-date breaking news everywhere, wherever you go. And, you know, also being based in the UAE currently, how do you kind of ensure that the news that you communicate is the actual relevant, pertinent information that you want to share and you want people to hear?
Okay. Thank you, Samira. And thank you, Shekhar, inviting me for this talk show. Yes Factor. Now, before I proceed further, for the yes factor, I'll say yes is YES for me. That is a yes factor. All right. Now, there are very good people in the media industry over here, Srija, Anjan, Melody, and other people whom I can see on the screen. Now, I'm not a journalist. I am not a media person, but I have passion of media. This is why we have started this media News Karnataka. Basically, there are, most of the people who are the shareholders in this company are non-resident Indians. The whole thing why we wanted to have this media is to go as a medium for the voice of the people. Those who do not have the voice, those who do not have a platform so that we can showcase them. We go for the people and the stories of people and what they are doing to improve their life and how they motivate others. And that's a whole area that we go in with all our products, whether it is English portal or Kannada portal or live shows or whatever it is. But before I talk, I have to say one thing, that what I talk are my thoughts, which I apply myself in my life. Viewers need not go with them at all because they have a free will. Now, pursuit means to follow. Therefore, pursuit of truth is to follow truth. Change is constant, but change does not apply for truth because truth does not change. So what's truth? That's the famous question Pilate asked to Christ when Christ said he has come to this world to witness the truth. So truth prevails for me even today as long as I follow the truth. When I don't follow the truth on a particular day, truth ends for me. Truth prevails, and I know one thing, when I follow the truth, truth sets me free from fear, anxiety, worry, and all negatives. That's what I've experienced in my life. There will be difficulties, pains, and people will condemn, and negative builds up against me. But when I cling to truth, I'm a victor. Truth safeguards me against others, gossips, hearsays, etc., and draws me to the real facts, actual investigation, and makes me win. That's what News Karnataka is all about. Thank you.
Great insights shared, Valerian, on, you know, reality. And with this, I would like to ask Bansi, you know, Bansi, while you cover different articles, showcasing different aspects of life, where exactly does this relevance hold? I think, Bansi, are you there? I think there is a connection issue. Let us move over to Nolan. Nolan, are you around?
Good evening.
Yeah, wonderful. Nolan, good evening and welcome to the show. Nolan, we would like to ask you, in the pursuit of truth, how do you, take action to ensure that you cover relevant information, which not just people want to hear, but that you also represent the right side of the story? Over to you.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. How do we cover relevant information, bring out relevant information, actually? Sometimes it's not easy. You have to get to the bottom of what you're actually trying to cover. So for example, the biggest example I could actually give as of now is the situation that we are all in. We are in the COVID situation. Since last year, we've had to largely be from home. And many of us, I mean, I'll be a bit selfish over here saying that I've had the good fortune to actually be outside and not at home, which was actually interesting. Now, on the other side, so we are out, we are actually meeting people, we are seeing things in front of our own eyes. A lot of people have actually died during this time. And I do know people also understand the fact that you do not believe the information that is being given by the government as of now. This is just an example I'm giving of the number of people who have actually died. So our duty is actually to bring out what is the truth, even though the government is actually trying to hide that. And that is what we have tried to do. This is just for an instance, Srija's there, she would also accept the fact that not everything that is actually given by the government is true. So as a reporter and representing a channel, a national channel, our duty is to actually come out giving the proper information to the people. That means a lot of investigative reports, a lot of talking to people, a lot of work that we have to do on our own as well. So when it comes to the deaths, I never believed what the government was actually telling us. 34,000. That was somewhere in June that they said these people have actually, the number of people have lost their lives in Karnataka from last year. But when we actually dug deep, we found that it was much more than that, more than a lakh in the back 20, 30, somewhere around that number. And when we put this to the government, they had no answer. So the point is, it's our duty to bring out, and we could. So this is just an example. Again, I'm stating that what we had to do as reporters, it's not easy. We just try our best. I hope that suffices.
No, that. Yes, Samira, you're on mute.
I think that's a great perspective that you shared, Nolan, because I think, you know, what we see as viewers and what really happens on ground can be totally different. And I think that is where, you know, the world and especially India needs people like you to kind of put it into the right perspective and, you know, keep that running with different opinions, and perspectives at the same time. So thank you for that. Shekhar, over to you now.
Thanks, Samira. So, you know, as we talk, we're also getting a lot of questions on the chat box. And we've got Joshua, who's a whiz kid in his own way. He's studying in Joseph's College. He's also making movies. And he had a very pertinent question when he asked a question about, are there differences between the subjective truth and objective truth? And I think Anjan has given him an answer, which is very interesting. But I would love Shreeja or even Melody to pitch in, if you could. Tell us from your perspective, what is the difference? Because for me, it's just the absolute truth. But are there differences between the subjective truth and the absolute and the objective truth? According to you, Melody.
Sorry, I'm trying to unmute. Subjective and absolute truth. My gosh, that's quite a tough question, actually. In fact, I would like Shreeja to actually take this question, but I think I would pick the absolute truth because like Nolan had just explained this entire scenario that's happening, you know, across the country, across the world, it is so true. And what we see, and even like what Samira and you mentioned, what we see and what journalists like all of y'all, experience on ground is a completely different experience for people who, like me, sit behind, because I'm not a journalist. And, you know, when I watch the television and or I watch any different streams of news, we feel that's the truth, you know. And for me, I pick the absolute truth because I actually go dive deep into research and just not, listen to what everyone is saying. Because these days, if you look, we've got news everywhere. You know, it's just not your television, it's also your social media. We have so many different channels of where we can get news. And in fact, it's up to every individual as to which particular news they would like to pick and believe, which actually is quite a conflicting thing because, certain people say this is the right news, then certain other people will come and say, no, this is the right news. So who do we believe? You know, so I feel I will pick the absolute truth because I individually like to do my own research. So when I open the newspapers, that's not the first, if I read the headlines, that's not the first thing I believe. I actually go through different sites, different places where I can get news from and then base, what I feel is the truth. You know, but that also, could be different because all of us around the world, we've got so many different opinions and views. It gets a little difficult. So we actually are trying to figure out which is, the right piece of information because information is out everywhere. I mean, we all do have smartphones and, WhatsApp, I think, is the biggest disaster because news just comes on WhatsApp and everybody seems to believe everything that comes on WhatsApp. So I think individually, we need to make a conscious effort to see which is the right piece of news that you want to believe. So I do echo with Nolan because he being on ground as a journalist and, he experiences more than any one of us sitting behind a telly or a computer screen. So, but for me, I will pick the absolute truth if that makes any sense. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks, Melody. And, that leads me to my next question. And this is for all of you, because I think all of you understand the pulse of the nation in more ways than one in the various vocations you've had as a journalist, as an entertainer, or as a radio jock. And this is a question for everybody. And we can start with Shreeja on this. Shreeja, in your line of work, I think it's very important to understand the pulse of the nation, right? And I think India as a demography is very, very versatile, very diverse. And the language just changes every few minutes. Even the dialect and the food and everything changes. How do you manage to do that? How do you manage to do that in understanding the pulse of the nation in what you do as a reporter or as an entertainer or as a radio jockey or in your line of work per se?
Because isn't that what we all journalists are here for?
And the internet is not as strong as us, looks like. Nolan, you want to continue on that?
Yeah, could you repeat that question?
Knowing you, the kind of work you've done, you've been on ground, you've been reporting, and we've been seeing you on the TV screens for a long, long time, especially during these COVID times also. So you have understood the pulse of the nation in more ways than one. And that's what makes you so successful and so passionate about what you do. So, you know, we have a lot of students from media schools, journalist schools who are watching what you speak. And, you know, it's going to be very inspiring for them. So from your perspective, how does one actually gauge the pulse of the nation?
That's, you know, it's actually interesting because sometimes what you feel is important, people tend to actually not agree. Okay, let's put it in this way. Pulse of the youth believe in something else. The youth feel that this story or this issue is very important. But I believe it's all based on age group. Your younger generation is more into things that really matters to them. Your 30s and 40s believe in issues that are completely different from what the 50s and 60s, those in that age group want, and those below 20. Trust me, if you talk to college students or you talk to anyone who's actually studying and you tell them about maybe the politics which is happening over here, they're really not interested. So sometimes I feel, you know, there is this news channels and newspapers who are not trying to understand what today's people want. They still are in the past talking about, okay, you know what, this is the story that we need to give. This is the story that people will like. For example, be it politics or issues which they might go on every day. You might see in regional channels, or you might see sometimes a story that is taken on a daily basis. I mean, personally, I would get fed up. So I do not know how the youngsters are, because they want information such as in shorts. They want something which is quick. They want information that is just there. If they are interested, they will go and dwell deep into that. If they are interested, they will go and research more. It's like they don't want someone to spoon feed them. And this is what is actually happening today. So understanding the pulse of the people is very, very difficult. You have a different choice. Melody might want something else. Anjan may like something else. But we just give one single story or these other things. I think there's a mismatch going on over there. And that's where social media is very important. Someone asked a question also there. I think it popped up saying, how do you trust, you know, the news that comes on social media, and how do you trust that? You don't. And that's the reason you have to basically on your own read, talk to people, understand, speak to a large number of people, diverse opinions, different ideologies. Then you'll understand. So understanding the pulse of people is very, very difficult.
Very difficult.
I mean, personally, I feel.
Yeah. So Nolan, I think Nolan, Anjan and Melody, I think from a larger perspective, you've actually told everybody out here and the larger audience out here that there's a way to tackle fake news, because that's what we're dealing with right now. There's a lot of fake news which is around us. And how do you distinguish between it? Now, Shrija, I think while we lost connection with you, we were talking to Nolan, and Nolan gave his perspective on how he understands the pulse of the nation. So, Shrija, from your perspective, what do you think? Or rather, what are your insights on this?
Well, yeah, I just couldn't hear what Nolan was also saying. I just reconnected. As far as the pulse of the nation, again, like I said, we are, we are journalists. We are responsible, and also we're working for one particular, a person or even entity for that matter. So when you're talking about pulse of the nation, if you're asking me as an individual, it wouldn't really matter, because I cannot have that liberty to choose and decide what really should I go with the pulse of the nation, because, you know, the pulse of the nation is just everywhere. It's just out there. You don't really have something where a person would say, this is what we are able to resonate with. This is what is happening, because everything is happening everywhere. So it all depends upon what people would like to, consume. And that also depends upon, especially like how I did point to the fact that the fabric of society has completely changed. You know, right now, today, if you're talking about news, the news that really comes out of the print, or even for that matter, electronic media, your narrative has completely changed. It's not something that people really want to read. Because when personally, I meet various kinds of people, you know, different sets of people. It could be youngsters, teenagers, or even adolescents, even, elderly people. Their mindsets are different. So they, you know, what they would like to consume news is everything there. There is not a particular channel who would just, put out one news that will benefit only one set of people. So the pulse of the nation is so very difficult to actually segregate and say, this is what the pulse is. Because if you're asking me in particular, like, can you tell us what really is the pulse? I believe social media dominates the pulse of the nation rather than the television and the print.
Yeah, that's
where we are right now.
Yeah, I think what is sorely missing is storytelling. I feel
yes.
So gone totally out of the window. And
true.
They're only looking at the optics. And on that storytelling note, Anjan, I have to ask you this. It's not just the pulse of the nation, but I think you've understood the pulse of the world also, looking at your domain and from where you've come in. Anjan, I would love your perspective on this. Like, how does one gauge this, the pulse?
Shekhar, it's like you just read my mind as I was typing out an answer to Pearl. Because she said pulse of, as a citizen of India, and I immediately said as a citizen of humanity in the chat, and I think you read my mind. And all these labels and boundaries that we put on ourselves as journalist, RJ, not journalist, not media person, media lover, these are simply labels that we are attached to. And in the perspective of truth, they don't make any difference to anybody, even to us, because these are identities that we use to communicate with each other, to kind of have a, like my, the name I've chosen is Anjan. So the name you've chosen is Sameer, so that we can address each other in a certain way. Now, if your name wasn't Sameer, would it change the truth of who you are? It wouldn't. You'd still be this amazing guy with beautiful long hair and with great skill and talent, right? So similarly, any identity we choose, I'm an Indian, I'm a journalist, as long as it doesn't provide a boundary and doesn't make us go beyond and discover our true experiential truth, then it's okay. But I feel, unfortunately or fortunately, we are too stuck on these labels and boundaries. And so, and Nolan said this, Melody said this, Srija said this, I think, if we can be open-minded enough to welcome perspectives, multiple narratives, different biases, and then we decide, okay, this bias works for us. This perspective doesn't work for us. And each human has to grow to the maturity of figuring out what bias and perspective they want to choose, depending on what narrative is connected to them based on their culture, their nationality, their influence, their education, their society, their indoctrinations, their programming, then we would really have peace in the world of news and journalism. And nobody would have conflict what news is good news or what news is bad news, because all news, honestly, is fake news. Because it comes from somebody else's perspective. And I'm not saying fake as a bad thing. I'm saying it as nothing is real till you make it. And you can choose what story to say, make your story magnificent.
Absolutely, making a story magnificent. So, Anjan, you know, just to add to what all of you were telling, you know, in the last episode, Samira, if you would remember, we had spoken about books. And we had spoken about The Art of War, which is a wonderful book, which I'm sure the Chinese have read and they're all reading it right now. And we were talking about The Fountainhead. For people who have read The Fountainhead, when you read it at the age of 18, when you read it at the age of 30, when you read it at the age of 40, your entire concept of the book changes. I think that's our truth for us also right now, because there's so much of information around us. And I think this is for the larger audience also. Many people are not able to distinguish what is right, what is wrong. So I think this discussion is so important. What do you say, Samira?
So true, Shekhar. And with this, I would like to, you know, change focus now, shift focus to something really different, which is sharing your own experiences and insights. So let's keep the professional part little away while we go to knowing more about yourself and what do you feel. Is that okay, Shekhar? Let's start with that. So Shekhar, I want to start with you in that case, since you agreed, you know.
Yeah.
So this is totally unprepared, but Shekhar, you know, when you talk about different perspectives, you know, can you just give us an example of, you know, the entire pandemic till now? Because I think we are a set lot of people who will always have stories to share to our families and friends and, you know, in history books, hopefully moving forward. My question to you is, you know, how has focus shifted on information through this?
So, Sameera, I think the pandemic has taught us a lot of things. One, it has taught us, we have understood who the real superhero and heroines are. The superheroes are right here in front of us. Our reporters, our people, our police officers, our doctors, they're saving lives. And I think the pandemic has, you know, brought out a lot of skills like this out in the open. The second thing is, it's also made us understand that being kind can be a strength. I've noticed that during this pandemic, a lot of people have moved, instead of the government doing what it has been doing, the citizens have been collectively coming together and making things happen. So I think it's all an example of collective leadership. And we've all come in together as a common voice, because when you see death up and close, nothing can beat that, right? And I think that's what the pandemic has taught. I think it's made the boundaries smaller. The fact that we've got somebody who's sitting in Dubai, we've got Melody who's in Bangalore, we've got Valerian who's in Dubai, we've got people from all parts of the world on this very interesting platform. So either you can look at a Zoom platform and say, oh my God, there's no energy of a live atmosphere. Or you can look at it and say, my God, we're getting all these wonderful voices together. So I think there's an opportunity everywhere. And it's also made us realize that, you know, life is too short, because we have all lost our close ones during this pandemic, which has made all of us a little bit more humane, I would say. It has also made us realize the value of love, value of connections. It's also made us realize that that's what this talk show is all about.
Amazing, Shekhar. And we have Bansi Kalappa, who's just joined us. Bansi, welcome on board. Yeah, if you could unmute yourself. Well, we are asking, you know, our guest speakers here from the media as to what has been their transition and perception during the pandemic. But before asking you this question, let me quickly ask Srija and Valerian. Srija, if you can start. Can you quickly take us through, you know, your experience and how you have come out? What are your thoughts on this transition?
Yeah, the pandemic has been tough, you know, maybe differently for different people.
Yeah.
And but we are all in this together. So for me, if I have to say, I really never thought, you know, being in television medium, like for at least about now 9 years, I really never thought that we could actually sit back at home and do reporting. That was not something that I really thought was possible. But what we used to do is we did, of course, for the first time ever, we got the chance to work from home. And this is because of the pandemic. And that was, of course, an experimental basis. You know, if you're talking about the anchors had to set up the entire, like, just like a studio set up back home. You know, for us reporters, at least for me, I have a 2-year-old baby. And, you know, with him, and then, you know, having him around and then reporting, having him scream on while alive on television. So all this kind of commotion and things were happening. But I believe that this is how we are actually realizing there is something to change, because this is not something that we had foreseen that, you know, this is what we can do, or this is what can happen, especially for television journalists. But what is one challenge that I still face is, as far as a television journalist is concerned, you may report news sitting at home, back home, but that is not something when you used to go on ground and report. You know, like I said, people as it is don't really connect with television news now. Now imagine and see you're reporting back home. They're just seeing you and you're just talking and giving analysis. It is not something where people are witnessing. So that is a part of my job, as far as a professional is concerned. In terms of personal, if you're really asking the COVID time, yes, of course, it's been very tough, because So I was down with COVID last year, August. This is right after reporting in Kozhikode, the air crash incident. I was back, and then, you know, my son was just about 1 year, 6 months. So I had to stay away from him for almost a month and a half. And then I'm coming back after recovering to see him. And then I realized he's tested positive. So, yeah. So then I had to get admitted with him in the hospital. We, you know, back then, Karnataka didn't really, government didn't have a mandatory rule saying that, yes, a parent should also be there. You know, that time it you had to try and convince the doctors. You had to try. It was a whole challenging situation because it was, you know, draining physically and mentally as well, because my entire family, my parents, everybody were down with COVID. So to deal with it and to come out of it was really a difficult time. And of course, my office did, you know, they did stand by it. They did stand by me. They said, just take time off. So that was after my maternity leave. The COVID was the leave actually I had taken. So that was my personal scenario as far as the pandemic is concerned. After that, I'm sure even Nolan and Bansi would agree. We journalists have been, especially during the pandemic period, apart from reporting from on ground, talking to people, meeting people out there. We go out there, we meet people. Yes, you know, the risk is there. But at the same time, we have been helping people immensely.
Absolutely.
Because you have no idea, you know, there are several people out there, you know, just common man. It's so difficult. I still remember the way that, you know, the people used to actually run for beds or ask for oxygen, plasma. We journalists were all out there looking for everything. So this is apart from the reporting that we are actually doing during the pandemic.
Great. I think a great insight shares, and thank you for sharing your personal experience. I want to quickly go to Valerian, and then I will move on to Bansi. Valerian, you know, you've been in Abu Dhabi, if I'm not mistaken. And what has been your take on this situation?
Well, Samira and Shekhar and all the guests over there, to tell you frankly, we were doing talk shows, recorded talk shows from 2017 onwards. But those recorded talk shows were to be done from our end and, you know, send it to the studio and then they will be telecasted. But 2020 onwards, I mean, April onwards, the whole scenario changed. We would have gone to a lot of places, whether in UAE or in GCC, to have events captured and then give the report on that. But the whole thing, the scenario changed. We have seen the difficulties of people, loss of employment, the hunger, thirst. And then in this part of the world, the people have suffered a lot. Due to COVID, because of loss of jobs, especially, and then not able to pay rent, and a lot of things have happened. Even the people who have worked in banks, they have lost jobs, and whatever, you know, across the spectrum, people have lost job and they have suffered. But what our media has gained is the live talk shows that we did across GCC, US and Europe on Zoom, understanding the difficulties of the people in that area through the Kannada or Kannadiga Association across the world, globally. We have connected to 60 countries. We have talked to the people, whether from grassroots level or through association, what are the problems they have faced? What are the help they have done? What are the issues they faced and what the government did not do for the non-resident Indians? Anjan, you said we should not divide ourselves by borders. But at one point of time, after 30 years being a NRI, I felt I am a not required Indian by the government of India and the government of the state. Everybody starts saying we are NRIs, but the name should be not required Indians. This is what happened. And in January 2021, being an NRI and a media person, we supported the International Kannadigas Federation, which was formed in January, which made a Twitter message to the government of Karnataka, crossing around 36 lakhs tweets from 138 countries, just to tell the government that they need to appoint the vice chairman for the KNRI forum. Because during COVID, there were problems faced for travel, people were stranded, there were pregnant women and the sick. They could not travel. A lot of people have suffered. But if there was a vice chairman for the KNRI forum, we could have addressed or the people or the associations, the NRIs, those who are prominent or all across the globe, they could have contacted this vice chairman, one point of contact, and told what is required for these people to commute from here to India. I tell you honestly, the COVID had a lot of effects on the, especially on the non-resident Indians and the sufferings they had, but we used our media to project all their problems, what they do in each area. I can tell you umpteenth of associations across the GCC and Europe and Australia, UK, what they have done. We have captured them. We talked to them through our live shows. And to tell a few, like UAE Kannadiga Helpline, Hemia Kannadigaru Dubai, or across Italy, the Kannada Sangha, or in Israel, the IKF, which it has done. Across the globe, we have taken them to the global level and to the government of Karnataka, that demanding that we need a vice chairman appointed. Now, we have conducted shows continuously demanding this. Still, the government of Karnataka has not yielded. But to tell you, we will take the voice of NRIs to the government of Karnataka. This is what the pandemic has done us.
Very pertinent point that you have raised, and thank you for sharing your experience with us. I now want to move on to Bansi Kalappa. Bansi, thank you for being with us today. And if you can also quickly share, what is your perspective on the media of today? What are some of the challenges you're facing and how are you dealing with it? Sorry, Bansi, you're on mute. If you could unmute yourself.
See, as a rule, the winner sets the narrative. Okay. So, if you look at governments, I mean, the present NDA government is not new. We have seen change of governments across the world. So, when you see a new dynasty or a new government, a new dispensation take over, they would like to set the narrative. Okay, this is not something new. This is not something the NDA is trying for the first time in history. If you look at the dawn of civilization, all of us know that the earliest civilization was in Mesopotamia. I'm talking of, when writing was just being discovered. Let us understand, writing was discovered first by the Mesopotamians. We really owe it to them. So right from that time, from the time civilization has started, the cradle of civilization is Mesopotamia. I'm talking of the present day Iraq. So right from that time, the winner has tried to set the narrative. So presently, the winner is the NDA, the present government. They are trying to set the narrative. If it is pleasing to you, if it is not pleasing to you, take it or leave it. They are trying to do it. So let's understand that in perspective. Okay, it might not really be pleasing for some. Some might say they are distorting facts and things like that. But, you know, that's how things work. So if that answers your question.
Thank you, sir.
The present media or the present narrative is being set by a particular dispensation. So I have no issues with it as long as we stick to the truth, because I have worked with Nolan, I've worked with Shrija, we worked in News9 together. So, you know, once we understand this broad framework, and let us stick to the truth as far as possible, let's give out the truth. You know, that is where we are. Of course, there will be challenges. During different dispensations, we have had challenges because they've tried to distort the truth to what is pleasing to them. They try to make truth malleable and ductile to, you know, suit their needs. But as journalists on the field, as journalists on the ground, it is our business. It's our bounden duty to tell the people that this is the truth.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, Mr. Bansi. And Samira, we'll have one last activity if you're ready for it. And I'll start with you itself, right? Samira, what's the first thing which comes to your mind? Is it Bangalore or Bengaluru for you? Tell me the truth.
It's always Bangalore, Shekhar, in my heart.
Ready, what about you?
Yes, I will go with Samira because I'm old school. So we've grown up with the name of Bangalore. But yeah, we can always adjust to Bengaluru, but Bangalore is.
What about you, Nolan?
Bangalore. I mean, even though when it changed, we kept saying Bengaluru, but when you think about the place, Bangalore.
Anjan, what about you?
I honestly have no attachment to either name. If you really want one more wrench in the works, include Bendakala Uru, which was the original name.
Oh, yeah.
I have no attachment to either name. Whatever you call it, that city has many great memories and feelings for me. So there's no point in attaching it to just a name. Change the name, I will still love it.
Anjan, I can almost see you 2 inches above the ground, literally, figuratively.
Sitting on a cushion, that's why.
Shrija, what about you?
Is it Bengaluru it is.
Bengaluru it is. Bansi, sir, what about you, sir?
For me, Bangalore sounds good. I've heard it all my life. I'm 52 years old, so it's difficult to change the ring.
Valerian, sir, what about you?
Sir, ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಅಂತಾನೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದದ್ದು ಆದ್ರೆ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ವಿ ಸೆಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲೋರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮಿ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸೇ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲೋರ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾನು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಬೆಂಗಳೂರೇ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ
In our lives, we have seen water cooler conversations and we've seen Chinese whispers. What really works for all of you? Because you all have your source for truth, right? Based on which we do our show. So what's it for you? Is it water cooler conversations, Nolan, or is it Chinese whispers for you? On a lighter note.
Both.
Both works. All right. Samira, what about you?
I think it's the, you know, ladies getting together and gossiping. That works very well. Yeah, we make fake news real.
that's an interesting point. Melody, what about you?
I think I would go with both. You know, it's good to have perspectives from both sides, whether, you know, you like the Chinese whisper or the water cold. So I guess it goes hand in hand. Similarly, like, you know, when we're looking like for the positive. Yeah. So yeah, both.
Superb. Anjan, what about you?
I consider myself a conversationalist, and the most important skill of a conversationalist is listening. So I study people. So I love watercolor conversations. I love Chinese whispers, and I love kitty parties also, like Samira said.
Shekhar, just one point I just want to make. So what I've actually seen, I just want to just, this is my ending statement, is like what I've seen in since the first lockdown and the second lockdown is that humanity is not lost. Regardless of religion, caste, creed, people have all come out together to help each other. So I just hope that with the impending third wave, if it comes or does not come, that we all stand together, help each other out, and just make sure that we are all safe. That is what we want. Let's not lose humanity. That's it.
Yeah, on that humanity note, while Samira is telling me to, you know, end it fast. I just have one small poem from Rabindranath Tagore because this reminds me, you know, this entire discussion is about the mind which is without fear.
And I wanted to end with you. So let me say it before you. Yeah. As journalists, I feel our job is to help humanity go through all these tough phases by telling them that this too shall pass. And this is my wish for all of us on this panel. To really use our strengths and our powers, no matter what type of journalism or radio or media or television or print that we do, is to give the confidence that even this is temporary and it will pass and it will change, and people need to stay strong and confident and rest assured that this too will pass.
Absolutely. Absolutely, Anjan. Thank you for that very inspirational note. And it's a very interesting, I think it echoes with all of us. And, you know, I was thinking, you know, we're talking about truth, and there's a poem which comes to my mind, which is "Where the Mind is Without Fear," which a great Rabindranath Tagore had spoken about. Where the mind is without fear, where the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever-widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country
let
away.
My country.
Absolutely. And Samira, over to you.
Great, Shekhar. Before we conclude, if we could kindly request all of you to give us a one-line message to all our audience out here. We are actually running out of time, but you know, people have been longing to hear you speak. Starting with Melody, because I had a lot of inputs from a lot of people saying we want to hear Melody after so long. So can I just ask you for a one-line message to all the students, the principals of colleges, the head of institutions, the people from the corporate world and media who are present with us today, which is also live streamed and on our account. So let me start with you, Melody. One word of yours to the world.
Thank you, Samira. First of all, I'd mentioned it right in the beginning, you know, great forum to get people from different walks of life to come together, share their opinions and thoughts and views. And, you know, before I actually say what I want to say more power to you journalists, you know, especially Shrija, my goodness, I just can't imagine what you went through. So respect, more power. Nolan, Bansi, and Valerian, all of you all belong to the media. It's because of you that, you know, we get whatever we can about news, because even though we have our mobile phones and laptops and whatnot that we can get our news from, but, you know, being on ground and going through what you all go through, I mean, kudos to each one of you. Have my respect, you know, whether it's on television or radio or anywhere, journalists on ground always has, you know, always have my respect. Now, also to all my, supporters who've been following me, thank you so much, you know, for being part of this. It makes me feel, it takes me back. So it's a nostalgic feeling right now with so much of love coming my way as well. So Samira and Shekhar, what I would like to say is, I think you should just believe in yourself. I've always said this to everybody, you know, be it wherever I speak or if people come to me for advice, you just need to be yourself. You need to stand your ground. You don't need to believe what others, you know, do, or you don't need to have the support of others, because if you are true to yourself, I think you're a superstar in that sense as it is. So be it whichever career or profession you choose, or even if you're not in a job, like, you know, we know that so many people have lost their jobs, and that is where you need the motivation the most, because we've all gone through really terrible times. You know, me being an animal lover, a wildlife enthusiast, we've lost pets, not because of the pandemic, but even through this phase, you know, because we're losing loved ones, we're losing animals as well. You know, it has been tough for all of us. But like Nolan said, you know, I hope that humanity stays and we will come together. Like Anjan says, this too shall pass. So, you know, all of us have got so many different messages for everybody. But I think we should stand our ground, be true to ourselves. And I think we can conquer whatever it is, whether it's the world, the universe, whatever you want to conquer. So wonderful. That's my 2 cents. Thank you.
Thank you, Melody. Over to you very quickly, Nolan. And we'll go to Bansi next.
This, in fact, it's a great opportunity. I'm seeing Anjan after years. Last time I saw him, I met him, was when I was in Midday, I think in 2009. And after that, Anjan just disappeared, left the country and went. But lovely, you know, to get to see everyone. Melody, we've been listening for years. And I think it just got in contact recently. Shrija, so to everyone, I just want to say, you know what, let's not lose hope. We will survive this. But we have to do this together. That is it. We cannot do this individually. We cannot fight this individually. If we stand together, hold our hands together, things will change. We survive. That's it.
Thank you for that. And we'll now have Valerian and Anjan next. Valeria?
Hi, Samira. And my thoughts or the message, one word that you are asking for, I will say, everyone who is listening, please see around you. There are beautiful stories around you of the people who are in action during this pandemic, or they are working in the villages, whether it's farmers or doing agriculture or whoever, you know, there are fantastic stories around you, whether you are in town or in villages. There are a lot of skills. There are our, cottage industries, there are people working, supplying food. So many things are happening around you. To the students of journalism or any faculty, I say, just pick up your mobile phones, shoot some videos of nice, positive things and share with us. We will publish them in News Karnataka.
Wow, that is amazing. Beautiful sharing, and thank you for offering it to the community. Bansi, over to you. You're on mute, Bansi, if you can unmute yourself.
Yeah. You see, essentially, all I'd like to say is never give up, because so many people who have failed because they didn't try that one last time. So let's not give up, let's try, and surely success is on our side. And most people will not tell this on regular programs, but let's learn to love in a newer way, in a deeper way, and love everybody. So I think love is the most powerful, potent force in the world. And basically let's just persist one more time.
Well said, Bansi. Thank you for that. And let's move over to Anjan for your comments.
I think if you want me to just say in one word, because we're short of time, I'll use the word Bansi used, which is love. But you know me, I can't say things in one word. So I actually want to just point out there's only three things in this entire life of yours. One is everything outside you, which is a coronavirus, which is earthquakes, which is seasons changing, which is planets. How much of that can we control? 0%. You have no control over that. The second thing is your own body. So your systems, how your health is, your nutrition, how much of that can we control as humans? Maybe 5 to 10%. If you're a yogi, 20%. And then there's a third thing, our inner space, what you can call mind, thoughts, feelings, soul, whatever. How much of that can you control? 100%. So instead of being warriors to fight what's happening on the outside, if we can all work and within, sort ourselves out so that no matter what happens in the other two dimensions, our inner space is peaceful, happy, joyful, and exuberant. And that, I feel, will give you the vitality to help, to love, and to serve. Thank you for having me on the show, Samir. And
Shekhar and Samira.
Shekhar and Samira.
All the love from all of us to you all as well. And we are absolutely delighted that you have been with us for this last hour, sharing insights and not just information, but your perspective of life. I guess we have lost Srija right now, but on behalf of all of us here at S Factor, Pearl D'Souza, all the lovely people who have supported us, the interns and everyone who are with us, Joshua, and we have Charlotte, and we have Rebecca, and many others who are with us, a warm thanks to all of you for being with us. And special thanks to you all, Melody Austin, Valerian Delmeda, Anjan, Nolan Pinto, Bansi Kalapa, and Srija for being with us here today. Thank you for pursuing truth and enlightening our lives. Over to you, Shekhar.
Thank you, Samira. I think, Samira, you said it all. And for the larger audience, I think Anjan, Melody, Valerian sir, Nolan, Bansi, and Bansi sir, and Srija. You know, the audience we have today is all young, impressionable minds. And somewhere the kind of question they've asked has made an impact in terms of what you have said and what they've understood. So all credit goes to all of you for making this such an interesting session. And all of you are wonderful people. And I just hope all of you stay safe and stay healthy, because that's how life is really is. Right, Samira? Yeah.
Yes, very much so. Thank you so much. And to all our supporters, our sponsors, News Karnataka for live streaming it. We wish you all the best. Have a wonderful week ahead. And please join us for the next session coming up. Stay tuned to our YouTube channels and all the social media platforms that we've put on the chat. And can we all give a thumbs up? Can we have all of us here?
Yes. Samira, I have an idea. Yeah. Pearl, can we do this? Anjan just showed us how to do a dab. Can we do
I was just going to say that because Anjan was going all over. Yeah.
So we can do this. Pearl, everybody has to do just do this. I think like how Anjan was doing. Pearl, you got to take a video of it. If somebody can take a boomerang video, I think we are sorted.
Yes. Okay, I missed quite of it. What really did happen?
So, yeah. So
we're going to dance now.
We're going to, yeah. Shreeja, we just want you to start singing and we'll follow after.
No, no, I don't think that was, that's what it is.
The song you sing to your one-year-old child, we'll listen to that song.
Yes.
No.
Some lullabies.
Yeah.
No way.
Guys, after the lockdown is over, if you're coming to Dubai, come. We'd love to hang out. Let's hang out and let's have some Arabian chai and let's talk. Come. Open doors.
Thanks, Anjan.
And Abu Dhabi is going on lockdown from 19th. So, Valerian, I might not see you. I might see the folks from India before.
Yeah, no, it's not lockdown. It is from 12 to 5. It is sanitization. So, nothing to worry.
Yeah, so quickly, Pearl, can you take a recording of this? Can you do the boomerang video? We'll get everybody to do this.
Yes.
Everybody. Yeah. Samira, yeah. Well, you got that?
Yeah, I think
we look like complete fools.
definitely.
What do you mean look like? We are.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Stay hungry and stay foolish.
Thank you.
Oh, yes.
I just want to say, Samira and Shekhar, great stuff. Keep shining, keep soaring. I'm sure you're going to reach wherever you guys want to reach. Yeah, the stars. And it was so wonderful to speak to Mr. Bansi, Mr. Valerian, Shreeja. Oh my gosh, I think I should connect with you offline. You are just such an inspiration and motivation. Nolan, of course, I know you now a little bit more better. Anjan and I go back years. So we've worked right.
1999, Melody.
Oh my goodness, you even remember the date. Yeah. And to everybody tuned in and listening, thank you all for your support and love. And to you guys, especially Shekhar, Samira, and your team. Great stuff. Good job. Keep rocking.
Thank you so much.
Samira and Shekhar, our support is there for X Factor all the time. And now you have reached very well, you can say you have reached 60 countries.
Thank you so much.
Next factor will become X Factor also. X Factor, everybody. Thank you.